bro, it's there. Bro, where the f*** am I parked?
So we just got to Coventry Uni right now, super excited for this. We're currently just waiting, we're in the Herbert, and then we're gonna go into the room, so yeah, let's go. Hello. She's here now, so yeah.
During one of my breaks at college, I went into Selfridges in Manchester, and I took my CV in, and then she kept telling me to go back in, because she really wanted me to get the job, I guess. Yeah, I hate not doing something, or I hate doing something unless it's building something, I guess. I always liked reading like Hypebeast and Heist and Vital, these magazines, just had a spontaneous decision to like make my own, not knowing like what it took to make a magazine. If I experienced a lot from a young age, then obviously I'll be ahead in the future, so I started just, started doing this magazine, and then once that had died off, shooting with, a lot of beauty influencers. I just kept sticking at it, kept focused. So if I didn't do that, I wouldn't have been doing anything. I did some modelling for like Superdry's campaign. I think it was like the start of 2018 through to like March. So we called it Watch Your Tone, which is like WYT, which is like the abbreviation of it. We hosted another meetup, which was like meetup two. And then I said to him, well, why don't we, like we knew we always wanted to do something. And then I was like, well, why don't we just go and film me? Or film like a story. And then he was like, why don't we film a documentary? And I was like, yeah, well, let's film a documentary then. So then I've actually started something called Alongside Lex and Healy. The intro's out, the first episode's out, which is released 2 days ago, which was the first episode's a trip to London that I just did with Boohoo. So yeah, I kind of always look to do more with my brand rather than looking at it just like an Instagram or looking at myself as a photographer or looking at myself as like a videographer or whatever, or content creator. You've got to look at yourself as a brand.
I'm curious about what's going on here. Is this being live?
So
I drive and I keep him alive.
Like Sam Holder say there, so I shot him during a skydive, 7,000 feet in the air. Be harsh on yourself. Like, I'm very, very, very harsh on myself. Focus on it being a business. So yeah, I think that's one thing I say, and I'll end it there. Like, don't look at yourself as that craftsman. Just look at yourself as a business.
Thank you.
So good.
So I've just finished the talk, and now I'm going to do some interviews. So yeah, let's do that.
Timmy, did you want to take? I think you should roll with this.
Can you
speak
exactly?
Yeah, hello. Be super diverse, but you did say account, so that's the good thing already. Like, don't just be on one platform. Don't just have an Instagram, don't just have a website. Obviously, probably the most hyped platform at the minute is Instagram, but that doesn't mean you shouldn't be on websites. Don't be scared to post at 3 a.m. because people aren't awake. Post at 3 a.m. If you've got something to post, just post it, because people in other countries are going to see it because people are awake at... If it's your time, 3 a.m, it might be somewhere else, like 9 p.m, for example. It's all about mindset, really. So if you have a lot on, like, without sounding it, it's kind of your fault.
Who would you say is your favourite influencer or artist that you've worked with?
Alexa Stone, 100%. So, like, he messaged me whilst I was doing a wedding. We started shooting the next day. His mind works in an unbelievable way. Crazily creative. I actually met him yesterday. Just planning some projects, some game-changing projects.
As you mentioned in your presentation, you created Watch Your Tone. How important do you think it is for inspiring photographers to have access to one-on-one time with more established photographers?
100%. When I started, the one thing that I said to myself was I want to be able to give people the opportunities that I'm wishing for now.
Great, thank you.
So good. I never set like a goal as such because I feel like it caps. Like if I kind of say to myself I want to shoot for a magazine and I do it, then you, in your head you kind of like, you feel like you've finished now. So I set like an overall goal and then just ride the wave and get there, shall we?
But I actually had a few questions.
Yeah, of course. So
do you want to go work in a company? Do you want to go freelancing?
Yeah.
Do you sometimes feel underestimated?
If you're not willing to cope with that, then don't start in the first place. That's what I kind of tell myself. I've put myself in this position to do this. So any issues like that, like, I've
I've chosen to be in that position. Because the more you shoot, the more you learn. So with me, it's just go, go, go. Like, it's work, work, work. Like if I'm not working, if I'm relaxing, I'm letting myself down because I won't be working. Do you know what I mean?
So I've just finished up at Coventry University. Really, really sick day. Did my talk, did a few interviews, did a few one-on-ones. I learned a lot of people learned a lot of me, hopefully. But yeah, looking forward to doing some more in the future, and I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog, so let's go.